Morning.
Merry Christmas.
And to you as well.
Thank you. It's very exciting, a beautiful day.
Beautiful, yeah, we're supposed to have this sort of day, so they've got it right.
Yes. And how will you spend your day, Bob?
Well, I'll go to my daughter's place.
Okay.
That's and lovely. My son is coming up with his family.
Mm-hmm.
So only people we'll be missing are the West Australians, but they're a hermit kingdom and
no one
can touch them.
Well, yeah, and you know, the Premier doesn't want anybody to touch them at the moment because this Omicron is just being very persistent.
But it appears to be less
severe.
Yeah, it doesn't cause a sickness that the hospital rates don't appear to be skyrocketing.
Well, listen, you know, that's a very good thing.
Mm. And
we got our boosters last week, so we're happy about that.
Are you boosted?
Yes, we're boosted. Yes, hi, Marion.
Morning, Colin.
Hi, Colin.
Jasper.
Yes, good morning, Jasper. That'll henceforth be our name for you, Colin.
Yes?
Jasper.
Oh, Jasper. Oh, yeah. That's the last time I can go on holiday anywhere, I think.
Oh, well, listen, what's a holiday, you know?
As long as he's not called Jasper, or Casper.
Yes, that's right.
Because that's one of the wise men.
Oh, he's pretty wise though, Bob.
This is true.
Hello, Isabel. Merry Christmas. Hi, Reg. Reg is coming on. Good morning, Reg.
Everyone.
Reg is getting some technical assistance.
Hi, Reg. Hi, Craig. Oh, well, here we are. The end of another year. I cannot believe it. It's rather insane.
And I think we'll be having a remnant here today.
Yes. That's okay. That's all right. Remnants are good.
Especially leftovers.
That's all right. Whoever's here is meant to be here, you know? Yeah. And it's not always about quality, it's about quantity. I mean, you know what I mean. Look, I've only had half, okay? So
get it in here, sister.
Yes, but it's not about quantity, it's about quality. How is that?
Yeah.
Woo! Yay. Tony Mills?
You're muted, Marion.
Yes.
Oh, that's terrible. There we go.
There you go. You're chatting to yourself.
Yay.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. And this poor gentleman in the background there, still kitchen duties.
I think his name is Martha.
Hi, Gavin.
Hello, Marion. Hello, Rich. Hello, Francine. Hello,
Paul. Hello, Merry Christmas.
Hello, Pastor Bob.
Morning.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Hey. Hello, Chloe.
Christmas, beautiful.
Hi,
Isabel.
Chloe. Hi, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. We will do that.
Move over, babe.
Yeah. Oh, hello, Chloe.
Hello, Chloe.
Chloe.
The big white suit.
Oh,
Oh, just white red suit, red t-shirt.
Hey, Chloe, you're having gay rubs.
How are you, Nathan?
Chloe's having belly rubs.
Under their chin rubs. She likes belly rubs.
Oh, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, beautiful.
What does your t-shirt say? I'm not always rude and sarcastic. Sometimes I'm asleep.
Yeah, I've actually meant to change it.
Hello.
It's honest.
Merry Christmas from Lily.
Oh, Lily.
Lily.
Merry
Christmas. Hi, Leanne.
Hi, Leanne.
Hi,
Leanne. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Hello.
Merry Christmas. Isabel, I can hear you from
good
here.
To see you all.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I
saw. Who should I co-share with?
Thank you, Nathan. Harry? Thank you, Isabel.
Yeah, probably me.
Welcome.
You're welcome.
Under the bottle.
Well, the family's coming together.
There you go.
Is Jeremy joining us today?
I have no idea.
Okay. Well, I've sent him all the stuff.
Or if he's up here.
I've sent him.
Who is likely to run the Zoom next week?
Oh, yeah. He did tell me he received everything, so I'm presuming he's joining in.
Guys. If you want to talk.
Okay, sorry. It's been such a crazy morning. So Craig's woken up pretty sick. He's had a bit of an infection and it's been getting worse and he's not feeling well today. So we're readjusting the plans. Nathan's had an infection too and was coughing all night. So we're still waiting for our COVID tests from Thursday.
Oh, no, who lives in darkness?
Hey, it's Lijah and Hannah. No, it's Lijah.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, there's Hannah. Yeah.
Hello. Merry Christmas, hello. Hannah.
It's Merry Father Christmas. He died his beard brown.
Merry
Christmas.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, hello, Elsie. Hello, Hannah. Hi. Oh, she's getting so big.
She is getting big.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Must be on good clothes.
I didn't recognize this.
He's such a kitty.
That's awesome.
Morning, Reg.
Good morning. Good morning. Happy to see that you finished your kitchen duties.
Yeah.
Very impressive.
A boy's work is almost never done.
No, that's right.
And Reg, I love it.
I know the feeling.
Our son Nathan arrived from Canada on Tuesday and he has COVID.
Oh,
he's now down with Adam and Bella because they live on the central coast at Somersby.
I'm right here, I can see.
And they, you know, they are now exposed. So, and they can't get tested until the 27th. So, you know, prayers for Adam and Bella and for Nathan.
That's not fun. At least he's not on his own in a hotel somewhere today.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. And he's been, you know, they've all had their vaccinations, but, you know,
and yes. They've isolated him to a cabin on the property.
Yeah. So he's
A prisoner.
He could do worse, let me tell you. You know, he could do a whole lot worse. They have, we're calling it their national park because they bought 7 acres at Somersby.
Oh,
that's so cute. Yeah. Who's that? Who's
this
that?
Is a ringer.
What's her name?
Zara.
So cute.
Scotty dog.
Declan and Monique's dog.
Oh,
but it's a bit
so
snappy.
Cute.
Angus.
Egerton coupe.
Yeah.
You need a black one.
Yeah. It's old, it's deaf.
Oh.
Like the rest of us.
But like the rest of us, yeah. Oh, no, she doesn't. There you go. I better get rid of her. Chloe's a bit jealous.
Thank you, family.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah,
they don't like it.
Yes. Oh, Craig, I hope you feel better soon.
I will.
So are you feeling COVID?
I had one of those rapid antigen tests yesterday, so.
What did it say?
It's negative. It's my typical cold that I get.
Oh, okay. Darling.
At any time when things are negative, when things are good, negative, what am I trying to say?
Any time a positive.
The only negative, time a negative is good.
Negative is positive.
Yeah.
Well, we hope you feel better very soon.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah. Thanks, man.
At the end of the year, you know, when you stop, your body says, okay, now I can attack you.
Yeah, I think that's probably the case.
It's, you know, I found that, you know, you run and you run and you run and you run and you run, you stop, your body says, okay, now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Crash time. You're going to have that break that you should have had earlier.
Yep, that's exactly right. That's exactly right.
Merry Christmas, Mum.
Joy.
Merry Christmas, Joy.
Oh, morning, Joy. Mute, Mom.
Merry Christmas, Ross.
Hello, Ross.
How are you, Ross?
Joy.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Are you still on mute, are you?
And to you, Ross.
Thank you.
No.
I hope Father Christmas was nice to you all and bought lots of presents.
We're blessed.
How do we tell?
We're blessed to be alive, you know?
Yeah.
You know, when you look at the news, my goodness, you know, I just feel for those people this morning in Tasmania, and I feel for that, you know, family that lost the 14-year-old girl who was shot by police yesterday in Los Angeles. You know?
Oh,
yeah, yeah. She's in a dressing room trying on a dress for her quinceañera. You know how the 15-year-olds, you know, in Latin communities, she's trying on the dress for her quinceañera and they're chasing somebody and random bullet hits and kills her. And the person that they were chasing didn't have a gun. You know, so this, yeah. So heartbreak, absolute heartbreak.
Aren't you glad you live in Australia?
Yeah, yeah. You
know? And my friend Lynn, who, you know, we were praying for last week, she had her operation, she's come through okay, she gets home, and the dog has to be put down. You know? Just heartbreak.
Yeah.
Hi, Joy.
Hello, I'm unmuted now. Hello.
Oh,
good. Thank
I
you.
Can talk to you.
Yes.
It's awesome.
Let's stand this on this, then the camera will come up. Oh no, that's making it higher.
You need it more like this.
Yeah, what can we put behind it? There you go.
Should we make a start?
Yes,
yeah,
ma'am. Oh dear. Happening. All right. Well, Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
This isn't really how we plan to celebrate Christmas as a church family this year, but it is what it is, hey?
Yes.
It's the year of flexibility and being able to bend, adjust, go with the tide, and you know what, I believe God's blessing is his hand is over all these details. He knew where we were going to be back in January at the beginning of the year. He knew exactly how things were going to pan out this year, and his hand is covering us and holding us and guiding us in amongst all the chaos and all the change that's going on. And you know, when I think of Christmas, I think the biggest thing is that for many of us, Christmas is our homecoming. When we've been far away, it's a chance to come back and reconnect with family or friends or loved ones. And sometimes it's a very lonely year. And for many of us, it will be a very different Christmas this year. And but Christmas and home are very closely connected. And I guess when I was thinking more about this, Emmanuel, God with us, that home, that spiritual home, that no matter what's going on in our marriages, in our families, in our world, in our communities, our home is Him, that Emmanuel. And that started with Christmas. Well, it started before Christmas. It got to another level, maybe, with Christmas when He decided to come as a babe. Live as He lived, die, be resurrected, and His Holy Spirit dwell within us in a way that is sets us up for eternity. And so as we celebrate Christmas online, reflecting on who He is and what He's done for us, we're going to celebrate homecoming, Emmanuel, and home found in Him. This first track that we're going to have a little look at is something that I found that absolutely captured my whole heart and imagination. Some of you may have seen it, but I want you to think of two symbols that you are going to see represented in this clip. Actually, I'm really hoping it happens, because Jeremy, do you have the clip? I mean, Bob, do you have the clip? Jeremy has all the bits and pieces, and I don't know where he is. Oh, you know what? This is very in keeping with this year. This is Christmas. Okay, I can find it, and this is not a disaster. Hang on one second. Just have a chat amongst yourself for a second. Found it. Okay. So, hey, Craig, can you come and help me do this? Okay, Bob, I found the clip. So yeah. I think I need to share my screen.
Yep.
We're on. I'll tell you about the two symbols just while my technical assistant gets us organized. The two symbols are when you hear the music and you hear the different songs that are played, to me, they are the symbol of Christ, of His message, and of what He has given us in coming to earth in Christmas. And then when you see what's happening around these songs, that is church, that is community, that is what God is doing through His people. And the teamwork, the precision, the love and the care for seeing what each one is doing around us, that is church, community, family, body of Christ. So yeah, enjoy as we launch and celebrate this Christmas time together with this little clip. All right, am I pressing this one?
No.
That one. And then this one. Okay. This one. There may be an ad that I'll have to fast forward. And we'll go this way.
Seven,
okay, there is. Six, just ignore that for five, a second, because I wasn't four, able to
three,
fast forward two, and skip ad. There we go.
This next-gen mosquito zapper is one of the most effective devices on the market. It gets rid of bugs from any environment in minutes,
keeping you
and your family safe from pesky mosquito bites. The creators of BuzzBeeGone are using the...
Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. Isn't that a beautiful, powerful video of just what... of just the beautiful message of Jesus Christ through those songs and the power of teamwork together to make such a beautiful presentation. Awesome. I want to invite Fran, who's going to come forward now, and she's going to share something special with us and a word of prayer. Thanks, Fran.
My pleasure. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
You know, Marion asked me if I had a poem and about Christmas, maybe, that I could share before prayer. And, you know, I just write these things and I forget about them. But when I opened this one, I noticed that it was written on the 25th of November, 2015. And that's the day I almost lost Tony in a near fatal accident, you know. But that day, before I even knew, because this would have been done in my morning devotions, Christ had His hands on my boy. And I just want to celebrate that babe that was born at Christmas time. A babe was born at Christmas time, a mother's firstborn son. All wrapped in swaddling clothes was he, this precious little one. A babe was born at Christmas time, and shepherds, terrified, saw angels light the dark of night as he was glorified. A babe was born at Christmas time, three wise men traveled far. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh they'd bring by following the star. A babe was born at Christmas time, salvation he would bring, bright hope for all eternity, this child who would be king. A babe was born at Christmas time, true now as it was then. Shout glory in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill towards men.
Mm.
You know, God is so great, and we are so privileged to be able to bow before that babe and this king, and to bring our petitions before him. So I'd love you to bow your head as we celebrate Emmanuel, God with us, and ask him for the needs of his people. Heavenly Father, we just want to praise and thank you for sending that babe born at Christmas time. I want to thank you, Father, that you knew what our needs were ahead of time. Like Marian said, you knew back in January what we'd need for today. We want to thank you, Father, for each and every family represented and those that are not here today. We want to thank you that you brought us all here to celebrate another Christmas together. And Lord, we want to celebrate the memory of those who are not. And Father, we ask you to be with those who are suffering today. Be with those who are heavy-hearted. Be with those who have an empty seat at their table. Father, I want to thank you so much that we have the hope of eternity. I want to thank you so much that one day we'll be reunited with our loved ones. I want to thank you that on this day, we as a church family can glorify you, even though we're not together, but where two or more are gathered, you are here. Emmanuel, God with us. Father, I pray your blessing. I pray the infilling of the Holy Spirit. And I pray, Father, that peace and joy and goodwill toward men will just permeate throughout each and every church member's household and out into the community. I want to thank you, Father, for Bob. I want to thank you for the leadership that he's brought to us through the years. And Lord, as we celebrate this last Christmas with him as our official pastor, I want to thank you for him and all the joy that he's brought to us and all the wisdom that he's brought to us. And Father, go before us, be our rear guard, be over, above, and all around us as we celebrate the babe that was born at Christmas time. And I ask these things in the mighty name of that babe, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and let all of God's people say, Amen.
You know, Bob, I've stayed a little quiet when all the messages of thanking you for your ministry have been mentioned, because I am looking forward to meeting Kim, and I am excited to see what happens in the next little while, but I'm really going to miss you. You've been like a grandfather to our family, and I guess I haven't been ready to say goodbye yet, and I'm still not ready, but I just want you to know how much we love you and how much you've been a part of our family and how much we really will miss you. Yeah.
I'll drop in on you every now and then.
No, good.
Glad have a meal or two.
Good plan.
One at a time, though. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So, in light of trying to work out how we do this program online, we did a little video, a little nativity scene video to reflect on the happenings of the night of Christ's birth. And we're going to show you that little video now with the help of my assistant here. So just, it's on my desktop. So I'll bring it up first, okay. Can I get rid of that? I think so. And just reduce that. Okay, it's nearly there. And we'll get rid of this one. That's one of the actors. Okay, here we go. I found it. I've got it right here. Do you want me to press play or shall I?
You have to share it.
Okay, so I'm going to. Screen. Yeah.
Bring it up. Stop.
Okay, it hasn't started yet. That's good. So I'll go back. All right, here we go. It's amazing how technical it is getting these things to work. Okay, we're going to share screen. This one. This one. Yes. Okay. This is it here. All right. Here we go.
Happy Christmas to you. Can I ring you back, darling?
Visited?
Just in the middle of something at the moment. Yeah, thank you. Bye bye.
And said you were going to have a baby called Jesus. He will be God's son, so. Hurry. Right. And. Jesus went to Bethlehem and looked for a place to stay. All the rooms were full, but an innkeeper let them stay in a stable full of animals that night. Baby Jesus was born and the world rejoiced. One night, a group of shepherds were watching their sheep in a field near Bethlehem. Suddenly, some angels appeared and said, God's son has been born, so the shepherds visited Mary, Jesus, in the stable. And spread the news far away, a bright star led his wise men to baby Jesus. They brought him presents and praised him. That's the end of the story of Jesus's birth.
Ah, that was fun. So we were going to sing Away in a Manger, but my little circus monkeys don't really want to come and do it right now. So do I force them on Christmas morning and make them do it? And no, thank you, friend. That's what I was thinking too. So what we were doing next was an opportunity to give to the Giving Tree. Oh, boy. Thanks. To the give to then the Giving Tree. The video and the link have all been sent to Jeremy. So I think we know how to find them. There's the Give Freedom website. And if we want to go there and make a donation to support them, that would be awesome. Bob, are you ready to share your message?
Yeah, I think we'll find out, won't we?
Sounds good.
Yes, well, today we were going to have songs and music and all sorts of things, but we are stuck in this the situation. I was talking to one of my sisters-in-law the other day, and they said in Perth they've got two cases. So they're all wearing masks in Perth now. An unusual, and that day we had 5,000 or something here. So the Hermit Kingdom is well and alive, and I don't think I'm going to get there very soon at all. He's now talking about the February date that he set may not actually come true. So any of you people wanting to fly to Perth, go to Singapore instead. Well, today, being the Sabbath, it is a special time, I suppose, because Christmas doesn't fall on Sabbath very often, but when it does, it sort of interrupts our frivolity and levity. But today I thought we would just do what we normally do, and that is go to the story of Christmas and allow ourselves to allow ourselves to hear the story once more. Someone just sent me a text and it's interrupted my lifestyle. So here we are. You can see that? Yep. Well, we were going to talk about the subject of Welcome Home for Christmas, an idea that we, Marion and I, had seeing we were going to be together in person. We thought we would have a theme of Welcoming Me Home for Christmas. However, as we know, things aren't as they would. So we're going to just reflect a little bit on the story of Christmas, where this young maiden girl found herself to be with child. And Joseph, he had to sit down to take the news, because he said, how would this be? It's not something which I'm aware of. And I'm sure he had a million thoughts going through his head. Who's she been with, or what's going on? And he then had a dream that evening, and the dream told him to take Mary as his wife, and don't be afraid, take Mary home as your wife. The first homegoing of Mary was with Joseph, and the first homecoming of Jesus was with his parents. The child within you was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and in one place it talks about that holy thing, referring to Jesus, because he wasn't exactly human, he wasn't exactly divine, he was in fact both. And so the child that was conceived by the Holy Spirit. How that happens, we don't know, but it is one of the divine mysteries that has encapsulated the Christian faith on more than one occasion, in controversy and also in different opinions. But we're told that he didn't consummate the marriage until the baby was born. He wasn't exactly sure what to do, so he just left it to the Lord. And the text in Isaiah, which was the prophecy, it said the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. Paralleling that story is the census that was levied by King Herod, to find out all of the people who were of each town and count them. So everyone had to go to the home of their ancestors or their birth. And so in the heavens there was a star, and these three men, Melchior, Balthazar and Caspar, that is the traditional names of these three wise men, they came from the east, and they wanted to know what the major star in the heavens was. They'd seen his star in the east, and they said they'd come to worship him. So Mary and Joseph were on their way to Bethlehem, which in fact literally means house of bread. And they were looking for a place to put their heads down. And the place that they could get hold of was a feeding trough in one of the stables. You can imagine the odour. So it says they put some straw down, and Mary gave birth to Jesus in a feeding trough. And while that was happening, the shepherds, who were pretty rough and hardy sort of people, they got a fright and they saw this angel in the heavens and they said, "What's going on?" And when anything like this occurred, they thought either it's good or bad. And they then were told to go and worship him in a manger, in a stable. And there's Joseph and Mary and baby Jesus, not in a cave, but in a feeding trough. The scripture says, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news. The Saviour has been born today." That is good news, isn't it? Because a Saviour is someone who takes care and takes you out of something that you can't get out of yourself. I recall my sisters-in-law and our kids, and we were down at Soldiers Beach, and I think it's called Soldiers Beach down our way, years ago. And the girls had gone in, and they were teens and early 20s, and I wasn't a good swimmer, nor am I a good swimmer. And so I held back a bit, and I started to feel this toe under the water pulling me out. So I dug my feet in and laid back as far as I could. But the girls had been taken out way out yonder into the sea, and they're waving and carrying on. And there was one guy who had a tube, and so the 8 people were all around this tube. Some of them were returning their lunch that they'd just had. Some of them were really frantic. And over in the horizon, you could hear the sound of a chopper. The Westpac rescue helicopter had come down and was taking them out one by one. They were actually saved. The saviour was a Westpac helicopter. And just as they were taken to safety without the help of them, or the thing that they couldn't do themselves, the scripture says, "The Saviour has been born today." That is good news. And then the angel said, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." Well, the wise men were actually travelling while this was all occurring. The wise men were following a star in the east. And I'm not sure about you, but if I went by astrology today, I think I'd lose my job. Astrology is not a big point of our scriptural background, but for these wise men, they followed the star in the east. And day by day and hour by hour, they trudged across and eventually came to a place where they saw some people, and they eventually landed up in Jerusalem, in Bethlehem, where this is Jeremy on the phone, just hang on. And into Bethlehem they came, and eventually, yep, Jeremy, I'm preaching, mate. Hello. Yeah, I'm preaching, mate. I'm in the middle of a sermon. It started at 10 o'clock. I'll see you later. Yeah. Yeah, no. Yep, bye. he thought it was 11, Mary. That's why he was asleep. So, as we were saying, something about the story of baby Jesus. And the wise men brought gold, the frankincense, and myrrh, these three precious items, one to give you wealth, one to give you incense, and one to give you health. And so this baby was fated by these three wise men who we don't know their exact identity, but we don't exactly know the number either, because the scripture says wise men with three gifts. So, and these men said, "For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." And I like this, that idea that they didn't come to hail him as king. They didn't come to see what was going on. They weren't nosy parkers. They actually wanted to worship him. And I think that is our theme too, isn't it? Because this baby who grew up to actually voice the salvation that we each have, we too can worship this man. And the baby that was born, Joseph was told to take Mary home as your wife. And for the homegoing of Mary and Joseph, I'm sure it was an unusual testing time, but when the baby was born, I'm sure that they loved every moment that they had with him. Well, there's another story of a boy that was born, and you know the story well, of the prodigal son. He was a boy who wanted his inheritance. He went out in wine, woman, and song. And when he had spent all of his money, when he'd spent all of his income, he got to the point where he was down so low that this Jewish boy could only find work feeding pigs. Now, for a Jewish boy, that is a deal breaker. That is the worst of sins, because the pig to a Jew is the worst, it's the lowest. So here this boy, who had wished his father dead by wanting his inheritance before the father had died, this boy was actually down so low that he actually ate the swill that the pigs were eating, and this food that he had, he thought to himself, "The servants that my father has, they eat better than I do." He says, "I will arise and go to my father." And so scripture says, there are nine words. So he arose and went to his father. Those nine words are not just the fact that he decided to move, but they are really the gospel that Jesus came to give in a nutshell. So he arose and went to his father. And for us, that is the message of the prodigal son. Coming to his senses, he probably had a speech all worked out, had it in his pocket, ready to pull out. And when he got to his father, he thought, maybe I'll be able to convince him to take me on as a servant. So the scripture says, when a far way off, the father recognized this disheveled figure, and he ran to his son, threw his arms around him, and welcomed him back. And he probably got his speech out, and he started to give his speech, and his father said, "Throw a robe around this boy. Put a ring of authority on his finger, for this son who was dead is now alive." And the prodigal son was actually welcomed back into the family as a family member, not as a servant, not as a hanger-on, but integrally involved with the story. And and you know that the actual literal meaning of prodigal doesn't mean, like the way we use it, you know, every now and then you think, well, there's a prodigal in every family. We've got one in our family. I'm sure you've got one in yours. It just doesn't exactly fit in. we call them the prodigal. Someone who's wandered away, and whether they come back or not, that's how we often describe it. But the word prodigal means lavish, generous, open-hearted. And I suppose this is a story not about the son, but about the father. Because the father was the one who gave the son his authority. And just as the baby Jesus was given authority over humankind, so this prodigal son was the one who was given authority by his father. And so this story is not about someone else, not about someone who may not fit in exactly the way we'd like them, but this story is about you and me, because we are the ones who have been lavished on by the Father. He threw a party, and I don't know the nature of the party, but there was a second son. We could have all sorts of names for him, but he was probably the one who clocked on early, clocked off late. He wanted to make sure that everyone saw how good he was, because what he was doing was just it in a bit. And he says to his father, no way am I going to celebrate the return of this. He denigrated the name of the family. He's taken what is not rightfully his, and no way. And the father went to him and said, son, you have me all the while. I'm with you all the time. Why don't you know that? And the father says to this boy, he says, what I have with you is special. But just as we had the lost sheep and the lost coin, and the lost boy, this prodigal God, who is lavish and generous, welcomed this boy into the family once more. And so going home is a special time, isn't it? I recall I was in Russia for 5 weeks when Russia was the in thing, and New Zealand sent teams of people to New Zealand, and I was fortunate to be in one of those teams, and we're in a town called Kazan, which is just west of the Urals Mountains. And we lived there for in and out, backwards and forwards, for 5 weeks. And I was starting to get a bit weary of the cold and just the entire thing, not being able. I'd spoken twice to Jan, because we had to actually go to an exchange where you lined up, you paid your money, and then they would ring the number, and if no one answered, well, you'd done your dough. Well, I recall we got on a train at Kazan, got into Moscow, and got another train, and then we went to St. Petersburg. And in St. Petersburg, we found this guy on the railway station, in fact, a woman on the railway station, saying, do you speak English? And we said, yes. Would you like to come to my house? And there were three of us pastors traveling together. And we said, well, yeah, as long as we stay together, guys, we'll agree to this. And so we went there. We went and saw one of the Russian ballets, and they faded us because they just wanted to speak English. And so eventually we got taken to the airport. And at the airport, you know, you see all the Russian Aeroflot and all those sort of, but there was one tail fin, which I do recall even to this day, and it was the red, the kangaroo on the back end of it. And, you know, I felt like I'd come home. One of those emotions that we have when you're going home, you know you're going to somewhere safe. Just as that, I do recall also, I'd been 3 weeks at Fuller Theological Seminary doing classes and in and out, backwards and forwards, and having no time to myself. we ended up at LAX airport at 10 at night. This large A380 was being pulled in by the tow, and on the back of it also was the red kangaroo, or the white kangaroo on a red background. You know, going home is something special. Jesus was taken home by Mary and Joseph. The prodigal son was taken home by his prodigal father. And I would like to suggest we need to take him home daily, because when he is with us, we are with him. When he is with us, we are with him. And no matter how bad your past, no matter how bad your present, the prodigal God, the lavish God, will always shower benefits on you, because he came to meet his son. The son didn't actually run to see a father. The father said, it says the father ran to see him. And so today, being the last major event of the year and being my last message to you, may I say, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance and give you the peace of Christmas.
Thank you, Bob. That was just a really beautiful message. And I didn't know that about the word prodigal. Takes it to another level. It's beautiful. We have a beautiful Christmas song to finish off. It's not really a Christmas celebration without a bit of joy to the world. This is the version that's been done recently from the Chosen movie film set and time there. They did a big time of worship and released some albums, some songs. And it's beautiful. After we finish Joy to the World, Bob, we might come back for a prayer, for a benediction closing, and a chat. So we'll just go to share screen.
Let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare Him.
Let
nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Yeah.
Shall we bow our heads? Dear Lord, at this Christmas time, we thank you so much for the good news that came in the form of a little package, a little baby. We have a few of them in our church and we just adore them, Lord, and I'm sure that the ones that came to worship you also loved and adored you. But you came not just to be adored, but you came to save. You came to place us in a place of safety. And we thank you so much for that. We know we're safe and we're winners with you, Lord, and we ask that as we continue to honour you with the life that we live, we ask that you'll be beside us, in front of us, above and below, surrounding us with the graciousness and the love that you have. So may the peace of God be in your hearts, the grace of God be in your words, the love of God be in your hands, and the joy of God be in your soul, and in the song that your life sings. We ask these things in your name. Amen. God bless you.
Thank you, Bob. We love you.
Thank you so much.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas. Oh, my goodness. We are so blessed.
Have a fun day. I love your hat, Tommy.
Oh, here. I'll put my elf ears on.
Oh, beautiful, Krista. Beautiful. Yeah, I should have worn my antler. Fantastic. I hope you guys have a great day. And just know that you are loved. We don't have family here, so you're it.
Oh, Merry Christmas, Franny.
Merry Christmas. Love you guys.
See you guys.
Merry Christmas, Robin.
Bye-bye.
Thanks again, Bob.
Catch you all later.
Here we
go. Hello, Antonio.
Hello, happy Christmas to everyone there as well. And Bob, if you're still there, yes, thanks for letting me.
Bye-bye, Robin.
Know you.
Bye, Robin.
Hello.
Thank you, Antonio.
All right. Merry Christmas.
Catch you later.
Bye. Thanks, Pastor Bob.
See you, Christmas.
Bye-bye now. Bye-bye, Nanny.
Take care, Bob.
There,
bye-bye.
Bye, catch everyone. Have a lovely Christmas.
And you too.
See ya.
See you later.
Bye. Like your shirt, Robin.
Thank you. I love Christmas.
Here it is, Nora.
Christmas.
See you, Nathan.
Bye. Bye, Bob.
Everybody.